In regards to treatment and chelation, one of the other things you want to do is pair it with detox support. So there's an advantage of doing EDTA IV, and that is that you get to pair it with IV vitamins that make it more powerful. So the interesting thing that I've learned, and it's kind of mind-blowing, is that when you include EDTA and glutathione, it has a synergistic multiplicative effect on removing heavy metals. So I've got the data here in front of me, so I'm not lying to you. So EDTA removes cadmium. This was a study, I think it was in rats, but still proven. EDTA removed cadmium at a rate of 6 micrograms per gram of creatinine. Basically, let's just say EDTA by itself removed cadmium at a rate of 6. When they did glutathione, that removed cadmium at a rate of 17. Oh, glutathione's a little better. But when you include the two at the same time, you removed cadmium at a rate of 88. So let's run those numbers again. EDTA at 6, glutathione by itself at 17. You combine the two and you get a rate of 88. That's nearly a fivefold, just shooting from the hip, fivefold removal of just including the two together. So if you're looking at doing 30 infusions, maybe you could get away with 10 if you combine the two together. So in my chelation protocols, I always include EDTA combined with a Myers cocktail and a glutathione in order to improve that synergistic effect to get even more metals out. When you do it IV, that's the only way you can get these high doses to get that synergistic effect. Of course, if you're taking the oral pills in order to chelate, it's effective too, just a little less powerful, takes a little longer. And you can include the methylation support, which is what the Myers cocktail basically is, and glutathione pills by itself, but it's not going to have nearly the power that it does doing IV chelation. So your doctor, if he's doing chelation with EDTA, make sure they're pairing it with glutathione. So in the chelation world, I want to make sure, I said in the beginning, but if you have heavy metals and if you have an overload, you must do chelation. And we call chelation as the treatment of heavy metals. Now, earlier in my other videos, I talked about the overview of toxins. So heavy metals is a type of environmental toxin. It is in our environment. It is a toxin we are exposed to. But it is removed totally different than every other toxin out there. It's different than every other human, biological, mold, toxin, and environmental chemical out there. It requires chelation. So the good news about chelation is it has specific drugs to remove it. The bad news about chelation is when you take EDTA, it does not help you with environmental toxins and mold toxins and human toxins and mycoplasma toxins. It only removes heavy metals. Now, that's important because heavy metals affect everywhere, and heavy metals slow down your other detox processes. So in general, I'm always trying to get people's heavy metal burdens down before I launch into heavy-duty detox support and triggering those pathways. Because if your pathways can't spin very well because they're overloaded with metals, then you're really just spinning your wheels and wasting your time. So make sure you're checking your heavy metals if you have a trusted practitioner. While you're doing chelation, I often recommend people to do detox support, but it's not nearly as required as, of course, detoxification support on the environmental chemicals, mold, and all that, but it does help, okay? So I will have a separate video on just detoxification. I'm going to summarize, but in order to support your detox pathways while chelating, you want to make sure you're on some methylation support, whether that's a B complex, DIM detox, NAC. I've got other videos on methylation, so you can watch those. And then, of course, a glutathione pill or some sort of liquid. Now, and I'll save that for the next video. I'm picky about glutathione. Milk thistle speeds up your liver as far as how quickly it can detoxify, so that's beneficial. This is what we call the pull support, the pulling the toxins out, or let's not say that way. It's going to pull towards the toxin, so if the toxin's circulating, it's going to kind of magnetize to that toxin, grab onto it, and escort it to the urine, sweat, or stool. The next section is this phosphatidylcholine, fish oil, and butyrate. Those are the pushers. Those are going to go inside of a cell, inside of a mitochondria, and push the toxins out so that the glutathione can pull it and grab it in the circulation and carry it to the urine, sweat, and stool. So this is pushing from the intracellular area. This is pulling from the extracellular and inside the blood vessel intravascularly. So it's good to do some detox support while you're on chelation, but the most important thing about chelation is making sure you're replacing your minerals while you're taking away your minerals with the chelation. If you are not doing that, you are getting into dangerous territory. If you're not doing that, then it's fairly harmless as long as you have a trusted practitioner, you're watching your levels, you're checking your urine for protein, you're checking your blood counts, electrolytes, and your zinc to make sure your levels aren't dropping. There's a lot more I could talk about heavy metals, but it looks like by my timer, I've gone plenty long enough. So feel free to leave a question, a comment. I try to answer as many of them as I can. Thanks, guys. Hope this was worth it.